Bhí bor a céadfach faoin trábal agus faoin nompur sa séo cé déag. Bhí an dá Mheiricá agus an India ó go líonú ag an Eorp. Agus chuir an trábal a tháinicé sin, brabúis deas ina bócaí sin a bhí i plé le tionscoir an lonseoireachta.
I lámaí muid, má tapu éiríonn an tír seo thuiscint ná bhaic leis na ranchers i lámaí tíre ach breathna ar a mharcaigh agus an tráchtamh leis sin. An cóhéics ina bhhar gráine leis i simúil, teap mid gur Ilán Iargúlta an Ilán Éireann seo, ach bhí Éireann i lár na an trácht sa 16 agus an 17. Agus bíoch gráine bhéil a ghil go an Spáin agus go Alban agus go Chuilát. Is Canal Transport Company a bhí in gráine bhéil agus an gró a bhí aici, a leanún an ráflar gur just pírád a bhí an, businesswoman a bhí an.
She was a strong willed person, a strong minded person, and she was able to recruit men to follow her, and they would attach themselves to her because she would presumably lead them on successful raids, or at least in successful employment as mercenaries.
Bhí siad a mar a gcéocht, agus is tóch gur rá beidirnach na dhéanana buíochtam é seoharach, gur rá smugléireacht i gceist, ar fá go mór bhí fín Spáineach go teachtarteach, agus gur rá fín Spáineach go pliúrseach sa cheantar Somália.
In Irish society at that particular time, you're not talking about unified lordships or anything. You're talking about aggrandizement of power. And you're talking about, particularly with the seafaring, the seaboard of Western Ireland at this time, who owns what is a very dubious concept, you know? I mean, she's called a pirate, but I mean, the line between piracy and mercantile activity is a very, very thin one. I mean, who is a pirate and who is a legitimate merchant?
I lár na gúdia chéigadaí is Skype call gráine mar chaptín farraige fornach ar chladaí in Iarthair. Agus gnó linseoireachta a thahar, agus cáulach na máilich á neartú aici. Chríocha gan smacht ná riail i bhí a bhargaí in Iarthair ag an am sin. Faoi cheannas gráine bhain díchas agus niirt an chhrú, agus an chaolaí, agus a scil ar na farraigí, luach sihir iontach amach dóib.
If you met a ship that wasn't from your own port or country, you tried to seize it. And these Irish port towns like Galway were by the standards of the country, of the time, very rich. Because as in underdeveloped countries at this time, the profits of foreign trade are very large, proportionate to the poverty of the country. Ireland exported raw materials, hides, wool and so on. It imported manufactured goods as well as luxuries. So the profits of foreign trade are very large relatively to the general poverty of the country. So these townsmen are bursting in money.
Sáfra amháin gún na galibh, bhí 600 lunga Spánach agus roimh an armáda. 600 lunga a roimh an sáfra a gún na galibh. Na Spáinnise sin an méid trácht a bhí agus an méid brabach agus an méid airgead a bhí le déanamh ón trácht sin idir an Spáin agus galibh. So bhí airgead an agus bhí le bourgeoisie i galibh. Éirí a lábh an trácht seo a chanáil in a lábh a héin. Agus bhí siad a barráil daoine ó taobh amháin plé le gná trácht, mar bhí siad éirí an trácht chanáil go héin. Bhí gar na galibh faoi siege, really, in sna blianta sin, mar bhí fatíos an dánar a faoi nó daoine fiáin a taobh amháin. Agus naturally bhí na Fartys, na Joyces, agus na O'Malley's éirí chuid, gwen airgat a héirú, agus bhí siad son an am é dhéanamh mar ba marnéala iad son, agus bhí smacht inte ag na O'Malley's ar a mharcaigh ar cús an cústa thiar. Agus agus bhí smachtach ar a mharcaigh, bhí smachtach ar an airgead.
A lot of the trade was maintenance by land and sea if you were in O'Malley, pillage and piracy if you happened to be an official of the port of Galway. So she had to be able to run those ships in. And even allowing that she would have had very, very experienced seamen with her, she was able to lead a lot of men at sea, not just from the land. And keeping that kind of respect, even now, would have been very hard, would be quite hard. Then it must have been considerably harder.
Well, an evil attack now, Goroshi Braher Furoik and Agoni, August Baker Scanlishi, the first Rana Himple, Ach, Tashajakar Gahid Fir Scanru, Ach, so Kaha Gor Higshid, Goro Tishkent Nisfar, Egevancho, Adolinchi, Ona Aher, Kaha Gor Hugshid Masti, Mar Higshid, Goroshi Nisfar, Ekenjob, Naro Shidson.
Her Granny Lenogno, Agus Len the Candle Trawdala, Rishan Spawn, Agus Le Dishkart Nahorpa, Ach Visha and the Hereb in Europe, Sashil K. Dig. We cogga in the book on edin the start of the Catholic Guerrero tradition, agus na tíre nu a chóirithe protestúnacha, ra an Spáin agus Sasana na gean fónaru.
An rud nu a hánig ar aig I fula tíocht an Seorpa go generálta in San Seuís dé, gná go rá fuinneh nu a I gúrsaí trada, tois gur chreddíní ar gáhéamh, go rá sé riachtanach dóibh an fíor creidge a chur ar aig. Agus gur higadar I go rá leisgéal nu acamh chun cuirí gune a chuid náide.
Ba tobam, chunicas éire chaitligach lena ceangail trádal a láidre, leis an Spáin chaitligach, mar bhagairt ar chósta thiar hasna. Agus mar bhealach trí na nonsach an Spáine, chaithí éire ghaolach a chur faoi smacht na banra na éilis. O yar gomach seal gráine a strachalt as a chéile.
Agus sin an príomh aharú a hánig chun tosig in san dara leat an séhuis déag in sa méid go raibh cuiristeach díreach á dhéana bheith stáit hasanna in imeachtaí I gcuid go chana. In sa méid gur ar ghéadar síos de bhunaigh siad a chuid cóchta in á luan, an sin de chuir siad a chuid saidúrí trasanna na sinanna I áitina bhfuil chun de roscámáin faoi láthair na huaire, agus an sin de bhunaigh siad a post nua sin é governor ar chuig go Connacht, nó the Presidency of Connacht.
Ceapú post nu, uachtar an Connacht, chun feachtas míleta na barna na Éilis reachtal. Cuirú tús le ré nu a réimas na Sasanach, údarás gan trua, taise ná trócaire.
Onig na Sasanig, na nua Hasanig, a bhí an fadastúnig, agus a bhí íraft ar siúl ach ab siúd, chun an tala bhí sibara a bhaintre mahtó a bhain.
The English officers are not civil servants with a sense of duty, they are adventurers on the make. They're earned to build up their own fortunes by provoking rebellion so as to seize people's property on the excuse that they're in rebellion, by extortion, and that was a mild way, a popular way of doing it. But English rule, instead of bringing peace and order, just brought more violence to a society whose problem was too much violence, and much more brutal and general violence, for instance, the wholesale killing of non-combatants, of women and children.
Níl aon dáit acu an dearcú a bhí ag na Sasana ar éirin ag an am, bhí sé thara bheith dúltach luitir go minic the Wild Irishry, agus bhreathadar gur jam thara bheith fiáin adúin stráinseir a muid barbartha go deibhan. Tá ráite ag staí agus saineolaí mór gurú an réis sin réon na dúdrach agus na stúirtach ar na réana ba warbartha agus ba brúdiúla I stáir na tíre. Go dtíobh an dúirt sé gurú gur thiil sé gurú na Sasanaí lea as a meabhar le brúdiúlacht sa sé agus sa seachtú is déag.
Is ar na clán a gaol ba bhú a himdaíomh an brúdiúlacht. Go bhór an drochmheas a bhí ag na Sasanaí ar ilghaolach ó bhíhead cine dhíthú á dhuine ara. Bhí cosint a cinnt ag gráine a bhuíochas gá thiar ghaoltacht ar chladaí chun mó. Ach go réir mar chua a cáil i méid. Bála ba bhú sim na gaibhtín Sasanach in a cut severish, a cut long, agus nyart a cuachta.
The English officials who came to Ireland had a sort of fascination with her, the idea that this sort of man-like woman was running ships and had a sort of military appearance, and they write about her.
Mo has the star grown, which caught the like state papers. This is she at the end of the August. This is she in the much for Maria Lerin. Once we had a nation par vegan as a Malaclia and Prive Governor, August and Shin and Trussa Hook, she said, Jerry, could ye London has in a humble, ye Irish boundary in the here the Irish.
Saints na quagity curric na Lorland Nashunta na Hern na Popperi Stasha on Bonrin Elizabeth microfilm. Agus is say on na microfilm show a been with in an allus all fui ruddy yen a grania nam shin. So being a lawn hish dockins na Popperi show, Marhamplet, Samila, Quickhead, Octodo, Shreve, Sir Nicholas Malby on Octoron Connacht, Quick. Francis Walsingham, Kyondon, a Hufigig in London, August Yenshe Turstel, do August Griffin Shefween, and Natirna V. Ichonopter, Ernomshin, the many gentlemen and their wives, amongst them Grania O'Malley, is one, and Tinket herself, no small lady.
Is on a Twerish Gishin, a Hova Eilish Erdos, Fim Gaptin Farget, Sir Bloodershin. A V Agamus Long er host the here na Hayden.
That is a fact, she was a naval commander, is the intriguing, the interesting thing about her. And that she secured such a high profile, not as in a coherent context of a single Lord General, but as a more or less freelance, yeah, acting over a wide range of territory. It showed that a woman could become an effective military or naval leader.
O'Harla Gurri Grania Vig Faimu Markianere Chlon Iwalia Is Orha a hit Kurum Lovin a Clinician in Yartu Lashtigan Huge. Vico Wolyach Lodir a Testalga Gerwaha O'Harla Gurra Aram the Banrin Eilish a Dinaga Gasta Hun Mo. Ban in a Kutrichadi about Grania Finamsha. Agus hí sách déisiúil sibhir. Agus rinne sí ceannas le ceann de na chlána ba chuchtaí a gonachta, mac ilim de búrca.
Well, bhí na máil sách tachtach, ach níru siad a réin le bhéle na búrca a chur bhí na búrca i bhád níos teise na iad. So dé tá rá, ní na sam bheith tá minteile a chuirt ar thú, ach bhí siad tachtach gomach in a gantar hain ar a gósta hartar ar chun mó. Vrahadar gur mór seans a bhí acu cuacht éigin agus brabo héigin a bhain seamach dóibh hain a moch ar an warige seachas ar an tíbh herd dhíbh bhí bhí na búrcí ró láidir ar an tíbh herd dhíbh agus bhí na flaharta ró láidir ar an tíbh oias agus sin informar sin. Gurdói gan ar na gráine íirach nasco leis an dáag jam sin le níd a chumad ar an tíbh chéan na léhé.
Wain gráine leas as an gócht a hog an pása seo dí, chun tíla co gólihe a dhéna agus a críacha a bhédó. Ach mo léan, is fánach na co gólihe gaelacha a bhí fácaí a gonachta ag dere an téo hí stéag.
The English formulated a plan where they had to civilize Ireland, and to civilize Ireland meant turn it English. In order to turn the Irish English, you had to wipe out completely Gaelic culture, the very culture that Grania had grown up in. So a concerted effort, a series of laws was introduced in legislation which sought to, on the one hand, make this the Tudor expansion pay for itself through taxation, and on the other hand, literally legislate Gaelic Ireland out of existence.
since in Huckdady is a Richard Bingham, a V Bunaha, a Quidcoct Bunaha Ege E Kashlan Warwick, a Bine on Rilahor, a V Rilahor Arson on Choroin, Egoica Connacht. August the Kershishin Aharu Bonusuk. Erin Quivlinch and Osan made Chinrai to be forced to new Ivaim, Shine Irukter Shul, or Forcian Koroin, a quid cocta, a quirarig, Egun in a Tishig, the Nasplak, Erin Koroin Rivishin.
A mass not Dwerish Kishli Hunter, a Hjol Richard Bingham, Golondon. V. Clauson, Gurjul to Gronje, Zlachtan the Eag, Kirch Yelia, Agas Harancha Ord, Erin Bowler at Mara. Vier bonnetje. Is frusta a ahend whirishki vingem, gor a roon ege, ean dunne a wananda udros a horfi hush. Dahen cha gor a force emptyhe a mas na glana gael, a chahi evrisha.
In Irish history, we hear of Tyrone's 9-year war, O'Donnell, the great battle of Kinsale, where they managed to snatch defeat from the jaws of victory. What we never learn of is the 30-year battle of the Burkes of Mayo and their allies, the O'Malleys, to retain a Gaelic title. And Gráinne is central to it. She is described at one point by Richard Bingham as the nurse to all rebellions. And this is one of the reasons why she is so important. She was in the middle of it. It's practically impossible to find a member of the opposition to Tudor expansion who wasn't in some way connected to her.
Ach vi tonchor agus cúlt gráine in a vacaige leis an gánarc a gonachta a chlí. In sin chárla an tobúist. Wása rúisteart an éirin de bórca a cúdeag 83 thrair scór blíon a bheith póstal a gráine. Vi gráine sna cúigadí inis agus í an a baintrach gan dár húid, agus ba bhú a bhuiil ná éon húid go dí sin.
She had followers, she had 1,000 cows. This was wealth, she had her ships. Until, unfortunately for her, the year after Éireann Dic died, the English decided to subdue Connacht once and for all. They came up with a taxation system called the Composition of Connacht, 1585-86. So it was another old go at surrender and regrant. Under the composition, growing a section of the family lost most of their land. They became tenants to the Earl of Ormond.
Bhí a tailoch ile go mór a mhuíl, agus í ag titim a mochtinocht go réir a chéile. Ach níor bhéan ribín ré í Gráinne, agus a clán a cosinteice. Bhí a dhrím a gonne na nailech mar a chosíthe ceán na min efigach a bhí ag bagart ag leic a d'iris, agus thug sí faoi gníomh is chróga an ngearna sí riamh. Gníomh a chiontas nach níon thar dearam ant go deo ar a henim. Rinne sí teagmháil leis an mamraon eilis féin. Cé gur iomaí tuairisc a bhí léite le fada ag eilis faoin gaibhtín mara troblóideach seo, faoin am ar tháinig achainí díreach ó Gráinne. Is fada ó réna cúchta a bhí sí. In a baintrach, den dárhuid, í titi in ís, agus í bó bocht, nach mór. Ach, lean cúd agus idir an bhirt vanrian árid. Ní fis cén fá ar thug eilis ard ar achaní Gráinne. Béidir go rá an díltseacht a héirí Gráinne luachar, ag am rá éirí mach oscailte á bhagairt a thua ag ónéal agus ó Dúnail. De réir a teannachais bhfuil Gráinne faoi dheire leis an manrian lena cás féin a chorfin abroad.
She went to London. We don't have any specific evidence that she actually personally encountered the Queen. Because sometimes with petitions you would do it through one of the Queen's advisors. So she may never have got beyond Cecil, who would have been a very important advisor. So whether she actually confronted the Queen, as the sort of folklore of it would have us believe, is open, still open to question.
Is in touch and vignette and virtual larger show. So didn't issue to a bach Eilish fashion dinna as an gnach gur éirí léhí in air sin cócht amhaint amachtí héin i ddír mar hasanna agus an sin nuair éicin tú an bhirtsháin seo. Neamh gnách gomach gachaíon duine acu ina slí héin agus iad bóla le chéile nár bhreálín a bheithin sin mar a dearrtha mar chuileógar ar an mala i géiste leo. So stóirim go neaithe sé sin i bhaim ar dhaoine.
We have in the state papers two or three petitions that she penned, or somebody penned for her, asking Queen Elizabeth for her rights as a widow under English law, because she was widowed twice, so she was entitled to the third of two different estates. She also asked that her son be given property, and she also spoke on behalf of a couple of other male relatives in the family. So in that sense, she was unusual, because she was the spokesman for the whole family, but she was a woman doing that. So she took on more upon her than normally a woman of her status would have done. But she definitely went, yes.
Chuir an díltseocht i gheáil gránaí go Eilis, thar ceán a muintire. Tús le ré eile a dág mac gránaí, tíbóid na long de búrca, ag tréid ar san nó sásanach, i gáthion táile, siadig agus hían. Mar bhuíochas as a díltseocht gan chrón, enimníomh tíbóid mar chéad bhuí chunta bhuió. An chéad heidil sásanach a brunú riamh gonachta. Bolle eile a gonne na seán ghil ach achtra a chinnte cinúint chlán ghráine bhil. Chá gráine deire a síl faoi thiachán ar chládaí chóin mó dar thug sí aigean. Bui í carraig an chála a carraig a thug neart agus cosinte a mbeanta deire a síl. Bhása sí go ciún gan tuairisc, ám éigin i mbeanta tosa an teachtú cé déag. D'aonáin go neartar sa seanachas gúil sí cura ar chliara. Níl éon aine se andó, mar dream eile go na máile a bhí ag rialú chliara. Is mó go mór an seans gur a mainistir mhuirís úil a cuidúí. Mar bui í sin an mainistir áitiúil agus gan í ach míle ó charraig chuislán a chála.
Tá sé deachar ará céadaon dearcú sear bechaata bheit agat ar chuine mar sin. Istóim gan íon deh gur duine sunsa bhíon si agus is na téirmí sin go cheart cuimnáirthaí. Léiríonn sé sin béidir ná cheat féchaint ar gráine i déirmí náisiúnacha is duine lasmógan náisiúnacha sí ach cinse dag sí sleocht agus béidir gur bin cuis gan chúis ar bhhair a cáil gur hiic daoine gur sleocht táchtach sonnach or ré.
I don't think I know any woman like her. I think she's awkward, and I've always valued awkwardness. I come back to the fact that song valued her and story valued her and kept her alive. Because she was important. That's the only reason.
Her legacy was that her children survived. That was it for her. That's what mattered. Her legacy is that her name survived. We know her name. Can any of us do better? Can any of us hope that in 400 years' time somebody's going to be saying, God, I hope I'm descended from that person?
Cén fáin a chránach sé gráine bhí si háin agus bhí ba himbal í agus heas si don chur a guine na sláhíochta agus an chur fi chuise bhí mar stair a gúin leis na mílte blí.
Níl ná dúthe de bhain tar ar an tanachais a bheith i gceannas go Polaitiúil agus táhrí sin nuair a bhí ban ann go raibh tríhéna ceannaireachta inta mar bhí nó anna bhfuil mar bhí si ganas ar a cinena hen ba cheannara í ba cheannaraid buintear bháile í agus dáhrí sin de chach dine ard fele a hurt ar van, mar benach na chanud gmach bannigannis. Agus de hurt is ard fele ar a fiaus mar rodi, agus a fiaus mar flanali, agus mar gwine ge generalta, ge viatach an pobl a vea brahide. Mar sian is mo vina gais lis na sgelta fe groin a weld, na gwraedig le fiaus a cwyd troddiwchta, gwraedig le a pobl a chosant.
Ni ceatam e siwch rha, bachorga ni smo mra sampla gronia a lanacht, gan an ffwregen. Ach o heb an cael, agus an tlishtacht, agus an balac polatúl a bhi eki. Bachorga ni ard ni smo a hwrt ar an intim polatúl a bhi eki, agus beda gomach ni smo mra a sail polatúl na heran an ish.
Gronia weil, fauli mara, Luach, Mohad. Tá iscéal fósa eris ó glún go glún. Is amuí sin cúis go maire na cíine. I neart, a páirtintocht, agus a cumas íontach linseoireachta. Tá réon rud eile is mar bhean ghualánach a chur tréimhse, huaite, chiannúnachta is stair na ngáil a chuimne for ora. Agus más le elementí go inscéal, mitas nó stair iriciúla. Tá a hennam fós bú sa lá inniu. Gráin i bhéal, banrinn is fáilí mara.
Agus a teach an seo thugann beidh scéal Dan Breen an ghríb agus muid a chur tús leis ra trí chlár buna é sí leabhar a scríbú ar luchra chugan na saoirse sin anam nach de céadaoin ag leabharí sinna. Am kinnu nach sa dara coga daun da sa skunan Flags of Our Fathers galua.
Kehe no kehe, an fermor is first.